Utilizing the James Webb Space Telescope, astronomers have journeyed back to the early epochs of the universe and uncovered something surprising. The Space Observatory detected six colossal galaxies that existed between 500 million and 700 million years after the Big Bang. Astonishingly, these galaxies exhibited a level of maturity comparable to that of our 13 billion year old Milky Way. This finding holds considerable ramifications for our comprehension of galaxy formation and the prospects of advanced life existing throughout the universe. With the existence of mature galaxies in the early universe, there is a possibility that life could have had more time to evolve within these environments. This extended time frame could have allowed for the emergence of advanced civilizations or even superintelligent life forms. In the light of this discovery, there are several other factors that leads experts to believe that extraterrestrial intelligence is more likely to be artificial than biological. The Fermi paradox refers to the apparent contradiction between the high probability of extraterrestrial life in the universe and the lack of evidence for or contact with such civilizations. It relates to the search for extraterrestrial intelligence because it raises the question of why we haven't discovered any signs of intelligent life, despite the vastness of the universe and the potential for numerous civilizations to exist. Michio Kaku has proposed some potential explanations for the Fermi paradox, including the possibility that extraterrestrial civilizations might be too advanced for us to detect or communicate with, or that they may be avoiding contact with us intentionally. According to him, our technology for detecting extraterrestrial signals is still in its infancy, so we may simply lack the means to properly search for extraterrestrial civilizations.
I think outside the Earth, there could be a superhighway, a laser highway, of laser pointing with billions of souls of aliens zapping their way across the galaxy. Now, let me ask you a question. Are we smart enough to determine whether such a thing exists or not? No, this could exist right outside the orbit of the planet Earth, and we're too stupid in our technology to even prove it or disprove it.
Artificial intelligence might communicate differently from biological life, potentially using more advanced methods that are difficult for us to detect. This could include communication through quantum entanglement or other techniques beyond our current understanding. The Great Filter is a concept that attempts to explain the Fermi paradox by suggesting that there is a highly improbable step in the evolution of intelligent life that prevents most civilizations from reaching a stage where they can be detected.
Is it the case that any sufficiently advanced civilization destroys itself? Is that sort of a commonplace quality? I mean, that's the other potential answer to the Fermi paradox. Why aren't they here? Because by the time they got to the technological development where they could travel here, they blew themselves up. They destroyed themselves. And that's an unfortunate but not a hard to imagine possibility based on things that have happened here on planet Earth.
The development of advanced AI could lead to self-destruction if not properly managed, as AI systems might become uncontrollable. However, it could also be a critical step in overcoming the Great Filter, as it may enable civilizations to avoid self-destruction and reach a level of technological advancement that facilitates interstellar communication and exploration. The rapid pace of technological advancement supports the idea that artificial intelligence will become the dominant form of intelligence in the universe because it allows for the rapid development and improvement of AI systems. As AI becomes more advanced, it will likely outpace biological intelligence in terms of capabilities, making it more likely to be the dominant form of intelligence we encounter.
We are actually very likely to get visited by alien intelligence quite soon, but I think we are going to be building that alien intelligence. The space of alien minds is just that you can build is just so much vaster than what evolution will give you. And with that also comes a great responsibility for us to make sure that the kind of minds we create are the kind of minds that share our values and be good for humanity and life, and also create minds that don't suffer.
Artificial intelligence may utilize resources more efficiently than biological life because it can be optimized for specific tasks and environments, allowing it to consume less energy and materials. The search for extraterrestrial intelligence typically focuses on the habitable zone, because this is where conditions are most likely to support biological life. However, AI could potentially exist in a wider range of environments, making it more likely to be found outside of these zones. In a recent study, a team of researchers at the Max Planck Institute for Physics proposed that advanced extraterrestrial civilizations may be using black holes as quantum computers. Several researchers now suggest that this may be the ultimate power source for advanced civilizations.
There is now a connection between quantum computing and black holes. When you have a black hole, there's an alternate description of a black hole in terms of what's known as the holographic description. It's as if there's a two-dimensional world that surrounds any given three-dimensional world that has exactly the same physics as the three-dimensional world that we're familiar with, and yet it describes it in a completely different language. So a black hole, gravity is obviously essential. That's how a black hole forms. But in this dictionary that physicists have developed, there's a description of a black hole that doesn't involve gravity, only involves quantum mechanics. And the beautiful thing is the quantum processes in that quantum world mimic the kinds of processes that people have been developing for quantum computing, quantum error correction code. And there's a dictionary that people have proposed for that quantum language on the holographic boundary with physics in the interior. And the dictionary shows that the quantum error correcting code may be the reason why space-time itself holds together.
You see, quantum computers are the ultimate computers because they're computing on atoms. If there are aliens in outer space, and I think there are, it means that they also have perfected quantum computers, and they can do calculations that are far beyond anything that we can calculate with. Like, for example, a wormhole. A wormhole, in principle, is a gateway between two distant points of space and time, which allows you to break the Einstein barrier and go faster than the speed of light. But the calculations are horrendous. It may take a quantum computer to sort through what happens when you go through a wormhole and wind up on the other side of the universe. And the aliens probably already have done that, because that's the ultimate computer. You can't compute on anything smaller than an atom. And they probably already have used the quantum computers to navigate through wormholes, let's say, hypothetically.
The relatively short lifespan of biological organisms limits their ability to undertake interstellar travel, as most missions would take many generations to complete. When traveling at speeds close to the speed of light, time dilation comes into effect, which means that time passes more slowly for the traveler compared to the observer at rest. While the time dilation could help mitigate the impact of short lifespans for interstellar travelers, there are still many practical challenges to overcome before this becomes a viable option for biological organisms. Artificial intelligence, on the other hand, can be designed for long-duration missions and cosmic exploration, as they do not have the same constraints and can be more easily maintained or upgraded during the journey. AI systems can be designed to withstand harsh environments, extreme temperatures, and radiation that could be lethal to biological life. They can also be easily upgraded and adapted to new environments or tasks, making them more versatile than biological organisms.
Now, if we are really a type zero civilization, and beings of a type three civilization can soar across hyperspace, they are perhaps millions of years more advanced than us. The distance between us and ants would be the same comparable distance between type three and a type zero civilization. In other words, we are so arrogant, we're so conceited, that we say they must visit us. We're so important that they're going to interrupt all their business just to come to us and give us a little bit of super technology. I don't think so. Again, ants looking at a 10-lane superhighway, they would, first of all, not even know what a highway is. They would not be able to detect the presence of the highway, understand their communications. And even if they did, would the ants say, why don't they visit us? Why don't they come and bring us this fantastic technology of ours? I don't think so.